Painter Margaret King creates her own work while her husband takes credit for the paintings that she created. This is my review of Big Eyes. I was actually looking forward to seeing this movie when it came out, and the reason for that is because Tim Burton directed this movie, and the last time he directed a movie that was based off a true story was Ed Wood, I believe. And I still think that Ed Wood is Tim Burton's best movie, so when I heard that Tim Burton was making another movie based off a true story, and once I heard what the story was about, I was like, okay, this sounds interesting. And after seeing Big Eyes a few weeks ago with my dad, I have to tell you that I thought that Big Eyes was great. The good points. I definitely think the best thing coming out of this movie would have to be the directing by Tim Burton, since it has that Ed Wood feel to it. And like I said a second ago, Ed Wood is another movie made by Tim Burton. And I definitely feel like Tim Burton has two different fields of direction when it comes to drama and fantasy. Because there are some of his fantasy films that I like, but when it comes to his drama fields, it feels like it's on a different level. And during the movie, I felt like that he knew what to focus on, and it seemed like he did a good job of directing the actors and everything else in the movie. Out of the cast, I think that Amy Adams and Christoph Waltz were the two best actors in the movie, but I think that Amy Adams was better than Christoph Waltz. And I think the reason that Amy Adams was better at acting than Christoph Waltz was in this movie was because of her character. Yeah, it was her character and how her character developed in the movie. Yet again, I feel that this is a movie from 2014 where the costume and production designs were done well. And the main reason I loved the production and costume designs in this movie was because it felt like it had that authentic 50s or 60s feel to them. Another thing that I thought was great in the movie was the writing. And the only other things that I thought were good in the movie were the editing, the cinematography, and the score, because I thought the score was a little bit interesting at points. And the editing and the cinematography did their jobs as well. The bad points. The only other reason that I thought Amy Adams was better at acting than Christoph Waltz was because of Christoph Waltz's character in the movie. And I don't know if this is because of how Christoph Waltz was acting or if this was the direction that Tim Burton gave to Christoph Waltz. But Christoph Waltz's character is half realistic and half cartoony at the same time. And I never read the story that this movie is based off of, but it's hard to imagine a real-life husband being this cartoony. And because of that, I was, like, out of the movie, because I was wondering, is this really how the guy was acting like in the real-life events? And other than that, the only other bad point I can come up with is that there were several moments with either the directing, the writing, or the editing that I didn't like. Because for each of those aspects, during some moments in the movie, it felt off. Because it either felt like the direction should have been on something else, the story should have focused on something else here, or the editing was a little bit slow in moments there. Like I said, I saw this movie for my dad. My dad gives this movie a 3.25 out of 4 stars, while I will give it a 3.5 out of 4 stars. If you're into Tim Burton movies, you'll love this movie. If you're into movies that are based off of real-life events, then you'll like it as well. And if you're a person in general that likes dramas or just movies in general, then you'll like it as well. Alright, that was my review for Big Eyes. Hope you guys liked it, and other than that, guys, that's it.